fine Tuesday, ladies and gentlemen. And better than nothing, as a Zan or Uganda. Someone yesterday, wait, I have to say this. Someone was like, Tina, ngo luzungu te tuchari ku VPN. The nerve. Anywho, my name is Tina Fierce One, and welcome to Scoop and Scoop. Sometimes I want to be as objective as I need to be. Sometimes I'm just petty. Sometimes I throw logic out of the way. Sometimes I'm just me. Then there are sometimes when I want to think half and half on all of them. I don't know if you guys get it. So I was watching a video clip of Salvador, and he was doing a stand-up comedy thing, right? And he had a joke that actually got me going. I was laughing. That clip was hilarious. That was the first time I was going, I can honestly say Salvador at times is comedic genius. So, okay, I know the line is stolen from Trevor Noah, but built to suit Africa, which is also okay. Anywho, Salvador, in his script of that night, he made a joke about airports, right? Now, everybody is mad, but most especially our Randy's brothers and sisters. Now, y'all need to understand, I am treading lightly on this because I am half and half of both. He said, and I think this is where about we know quite dako. If you do not understand the joke, do not comment on it. Ngenda chiteka kwecho. I know very many people are saying it's a very sensitive issue. How could he mention the word genocide and then have people laughing? It's not funny. We went through it. There were innocent lives and souls that actually perished to that genocide. We accept that. We accept that. As a nation, we do. As Africa, we do. The entire world acknowledges that the pain and trauma that Rwanda went through, that was a lot for them, right? Now, let's fast forward decades. I'm going to give you, this is my take on it. I have seen Americans crack jokes about slavery, and no one finds it offensive amongst them or amongst us. I've had Americans say weird things in a joke, of course, in a joke about probably an African country or something. I don't think we should be going there as people who want to go and watch comedy. The word comedy means you're going to laugh. There's going to be a guy cracking a bunch of jokes on stage, and it's his opinion, but you've gone for a haha moment. Now, I see all these people coming on social, Salvador should apologize. Apologize for what? Did you even take the time to understand the joke? Because he stringed that joke along from the jab. That was like, was one of my favorite punchlines. Not that I am insensitive. Young people need to calm down a little bit. I saw the Randis community, because anyway, Charlie Chikwata Kubo. But I'm going to ask you, shall we never mention the word konyi and gulu in the same sentence because it happened? Shall we never mention slavery and the black race in America because it happened and lives were taken and people died? Shall we never, ever say those two lines, Rwanda and genocide, in the same statement because it happened? I mean, let's ask ourselves, if somebody wasn't coming from a place of being, because that wasn't insensitive for me. I don't know. Maybe my chill is on vacation. But my take on it, I'm like, no. Y'all didn't understand the joke. It's okay. Salvador is not going to apologize. He's holding his own. I've been seeing it on social. And I think, as a comedian, he's entitled to having his opinion. I mean, most of you who have watched Dave Chappelle's Sticks and Stones know what I'm talking about. If you are offended, come on. And some of these things are the truth. Most of them are the truth. Ugh. Anyway, behavior, Salvador is again under fire. Oh, And I was surprised that I was doing this pants down challenge. Abana Uganda abasinga temwagitegedde. Mwagenza kubuka kupejize na kumugamba bana spice. Tukoye nyambala yo. Spice otwe yambulide. Empalo zisude wasi. Abagamba temundete na kundete. Sit down and muyonsa abana bamwe mundeke. If you don't understand this, okay. On the pants down challenge, I ain't finna say nothing because I understand it's a challenge. On how Spice Diana dresses up, you people need to understand something. Omuntu bw'omujjeri echannamukaka. No mulete Kampala. No mugamba, you can have all these things around you. Tawali abikugana. What you expect? Let the girl explore. It looks ridiculous, but hey, let's look at the person we're talking about. It's Spice Diana. Why would you even get mad? I mean, what's her longevity in the industry? Then what? Let the girl ball out. Kana mkaleke wa mbamboba maloga kalimu mkaleke ya maloga ako. Eh. Yee. Yee. Now I've been tasted and tried by almost everybody, man. Especially y'all bloggers out there in the diaspora. Ooh, honey. I have been tested and tried by these people. Today morning, yeah. Today morning, I'm chilling in office, minding everyone else's business, because that's my job, boo-boo. It pays me. And then someone sends me a text, and they're like, what your blogger kuliko katiali live? First of all, baba mpuli dead in ya. I'm like, who? You have got to be really, 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 really irrelevant for me not to know you. Ooh, child. Because I know all these bloggers. I follow all their sites just to keep up with the times. Anyway, this man can climb me. Yeah, oh, but talking about Josephine Mulzungu. Yeah, what? The man can climb. I can't. Anyway, he had issues with something I think I had said. Now this is what I'm going to tell you, bloggers. If you want to have a one-on-one or to find out how messed up it is up in here, and it's not just a mess, there's tons of intellect, there's a lot in here, hit me up on my whole pages. Ndetela kupeji yango ngamba, ha, gwechitina. No! Stop growing your social media following using me. In all fairness, since we are all of us should gain. Hit me up in person. Let's have these conversations in person. I mean, is anyone Peter could live? Why are you being cowards, people? And this is not the first time I'm calling out these bloggers. I don't have a blogger more just since Otomezaban to be Uganda. I'm going to be storing and be taking your opinions. Now, this particular thing, I don't even know what to call him. This particular thing is in another country, right? Talking about issues in our country. This is what I'm going to say. And I said it before, I'll say it again. Butang, Tomalawo. Battery simu kuba wifi yolina chocho nchimanyo yolina tomala ako battery simu salisa ticket jangwe Kampala ozigwemu. That simple. Why should these bloggers be the ones to tell us how it's really bad back at home when we are at home and we know how it really is not that bad or is bad? Like, do you get my logic? Mulekera wokwasa miranga just ku social media. If you feel you have a big contribution, take a flight. Because we are done being social media, like this social media poly tricking is not really, it's like you calling yourself a president on social. And then somewhat in your head, it gets stuck, you are. Catch flights. Don't catch flights. If you're a blogger out there and you feel you want to speak on the things that are at home, and most of you who speak on these things have not stepped foot in this here country, Teba kumawo. Na ye boba kola chimu social media na kuwa masimu social. Muje tuwasanga kusite square yanga na mwe mwimi di demama anti mwagala kuyamba gwanga. Muje mwye yambi de dala. Muje mtugambe tuliwa no chutoba na haba na Uganda babo na abona. Come on. At Cinevious One is my Twitter handle and on Facebook, we are Scoop and Scoop and a Tina Fierce One. Please, bloggers, let me do it just for them again. At Tina Fierce One, that's on Twitter. On Instagram, it's at Tina Fierce One with an H, right? On Facebook, Scoop on Scoop and at Tina Fierce One. Pick any one of them. Or your pick. I am ready. Pick any one of them and let's have a moment, okay? All right. That's it. Have yourselves a lovely afternoon. Good night.